If I need to summarize the whole field of strategic management in one slide, this would be this one slide. So strategic management is all about, so the mantra of strategic management is competitive advantage. So strategic management is all about actions, like which industry to compete, which product to introduce, which alliance to form. It is all about actions that will lead to competitive advantage. And by competitive advantage, we mean ability to create superior performance, or what in economics we call rents, ability to command above average profit. So essence of strategic management is all about actions that lead to competitive advantage, and competitive advantage is all about superior performance. And every textbook in strategic management today, when talking about these sources of competitive advantage, they would talk about three general things. First is all about having market power. This is what Michael Porter from Harvard introduced to strategic management. It is all about smart selection of your industry or your niche, where you have essentially a monopolistic position and you can command premium prices. A good example is Microsoft with Microsoft Office suite or other Microsoft products like Teams, for example. Whether I like Microsoft Teams or not, I have to use Microsoft Teams simply because everyone else in my ecosystem is using Microsoft Teams. So Microsoft has market power, which allows it to have superior performance. The second source of competitive advantage is having unique resources and capabilities. Something that is valuable, rare, inimitable, non-substitutable. So usually every textbook in strategy, chapter number 3 is about selecting the industry, analyzing the industry, which is all about market power. Chapter number 4 is all about unique resources, how to look internally into your strengths of your organization, how to develop something that nobody else has, something that is valuable. Unique resources, for example, in this particular slide, it is a lens. It is Canon or Nikon lens. So Canon and Nikon photography are two companies, particular Canon, that is known for their precise optics. And then this is their unique resource, unique know-how of producing precise optics. And then they can use this unique resource in order to produce cameras, lenses, copying material, copying equipment, printing equipment, and so on. The third source of superior performance is something called innovator's advantage. Innovator's advantage is all about constant innovating and charging your customers premium prices until you get imitated by competitors. Good example is Apple in Steve Jobs' time, when Apple introduced a new great, radical new product every 18 months, and up until Samsung was able to catch up, Apple was able to charge whatever they wanted from their loyal customers. Now, here is a trick. Why I am even talking about all of this? All of these sources of competitive advantage are tightly coupled with overcoming uncertainty, with overcoming true uncertainty. Let's take a look at each of them. Market power. In order to get market power, you have to usually enter into an industry being the first. You don't know in advance whether it will work or not. You have to overcome major uncertainty. For every Microsoft that is out there, there is hundreds and hundreds of other companies that tried to do what Microsoft did with their Office suites, but failed. So market power, you cannot buy it. If you are trying to buy market power, if you are trying to buy Microsoft right now, you have to overpay for it. You have to develop market power. And the market power is developed through initial entrepreneurial actions, through overcoming major uncertainty. When nobody knew back 30 years ago whether what Microsoft was doing will be a success or not. If we look at unique resources, well, you can go and try to buy them on the open market, but the only problem is that whoever is selling these unique resources to you, they will charge you all the possible profit from this unique resource. So, in most cases, unique resources, valuable capabilities and competences have to be developed internally. For many years, Canon has been investing into R&D in precise optics in order to understand how to do it. And there was no guarantee a priori that this will work. Canon had to overcome major uncertainty. And now uncertainty is resolved in its favor and Canon has this unique resource. Finally, innovator's advantage. So innovator's advantage is all about constant innovating. Constant innovating is all about constantly overcoming the uncertainty. So every time Apple introduces a new product, there is a huge chance that it will be a flop. And right now, looking backwards, it seems like that everything was predicted, that iPad had to be a success, iPhone had to be a success. But actually it is not. Apple had to overcome major uncertainty, and they overcame it successfully. So, essence of strategic management is all about finding ways to build competitive advantage. The point I'm trying to make is that it is always related to overcoming major uncertainty. That's why entrepreneurial thinking are at the core of strategic management. Entrepreneurial thinking is all about doing some actions in order to build market power, in order to acquire unique resources, or in order to constantly innovate. And all the things that we are going to discuss in entrepreneurial thinking, they are applicable to strategic management.